Perth's residential housing market has experienced growth in October, with the CoreLogic Home Value Index increasing 0.6% when compared to September and 0.9% over the quarter. To find out all the details, stay tuned for our November market update. G'day guys, my name's Tim Guest and welcome to our market update video series where you can stay up to date with the market's matter, and find out what's happening in your local area. Now please remember to like, comment and share this video, and if it's your first time tuning in, don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. So REWA President Damien Collins said in late 2019, REWA believed that the new year would see increased market activity in Perth. A year later, and despite the COVID-19 pandemic, the West Australian property market has certainly seen this. Mr. Collins said, when comparing October 2020 REWA.com data to October 2019, sales volume has increased 2.7%. Breaking it down, houses saw a 7% annual increase, units increased by over 20%, and land decreased 27%. The decrease in land was lessened by the higher number of sales due to the Home Builder Grant, which certainly picked up the number of overall annual sales. However, it's still pleasing to see houses and units performing quite well, Mr. Collins said. The suburb to see the biggest spike in sales activity growth in October was Yanchep, with 133% increase, and that's predominantly due to the large number of land sales. That was followed by East Victoria Park, 100% increase, Cloverdale, 86%, Hammond Park, 67%, and Ailey, 63%. Mr. Collins said, not only have stock levels decreased with 10,272 properties for sale on REWA.com, which is 27.8% less than this time last year, but the median days to sell has also lowered by 25 days, 3 days quicker than September and 22 days quicker than October last year. With Perth's residential rental market currently in crisis, and that's with a vacancy rate of under 1%, it seems the situation is getting worse, with October's rental data showing that stock levels continue to drop and rents have started increasing. Mr. Collins said after 24 months of a constant median rent price of $350 per week, in just 3 months, there has been a $25 a week jump to $375. Mr. Collins said the median rent for houses increased $35 per week over the 3 months to $395 per week, and units increased $20 to $350 per week. With a continued low vacancy rate putting upward pressure on rents, we can expect to see further increases over the coming months. Now, Southern River was the top performing suburb by median weekly rent in October, with a 3.8% increase to $420 per week. And this was closely followed by Armidale, up 3.2% with $270, Butler up 3.2% at $320, Subiaco up 2.9% to $650, and Ellenbrook up 2.9% to $650. Mr. Collins said October REWA.com data reinforces that we're undergoing a serious rental shortage, with listings for rent decreasing by more than half and leasing activity reducing almost a third when compared to October 2019. He also said the median days to lease in October is the quickest it has been since April 2013, taking only 18 days, with agents on the ground reporting that some properties are leasing within days of a listing going live on REWA.com. Well, guys, that's it from me today. Now, please like, comment, share this video, and don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. Have a great week, and remember, it's only one thing in life that makes a difference. That's action. Thanks a lot. Bye for now.